Hello, this is Todd Baginski. I'm a Microsoft MVP and the partner and CTO at Canvas Consulting. In this video, I'm going to take you on a deep dive of the QuickTask PowerApp sample template. And inside of it, I'm going to show you how to integrate Microsoft Planner into PowerApps. If you haven't seen my other videos about the QuickTask's PowerApp sample template before, I encourage you to check them out. One of the videos shows you how to set up and configure it, and the other one shows you all the functionality inside of the PowerApp sample template we call QuickTask. After you've installed the QuickTask PowerApp sample template, you will see it appear in your list of PowerApps just like I have here. I'd like to take you on a little demonstration of the Planner integration in this PowerApp before we dive into the code and how it was built. On the left side of the app, when you open it, it looks just like this. Here you can see the emails that come from a distribution list that you've configured the app to watch. It's using the Outlook connector to get the emails that you see on the left, and you can see when I click them, the details about the email change here in the middle, as well as the information that's pre-populated into the name of the task and the description for the task we will create in Planner. So here you can see again, I'll flip from one to the other, and you can watch that content change throughout the page. But the part we're focused on in this particular video is the integration with Planner. And that's really everything in the right side here in this Create Task pane. Now, I'd like to bring your attention to this plan that I have created in Planner. It's called Power Apps and Flow Applications. And right now, it does not have any tasks. It has two buckets, one called Urgent and one called To Do. Returning to the QuickTask's PowerApp sample, I'll select Demo Email 6 and pre-populate the name of the task I wish to create in Planner, as well as the description I wish to create for it as well. I can then enter in more information here as I see fit and put that into the body of the tasks that we create. I also have the ability to select which plan I'd like to put it in. If I don't see the plan I'd like to put it in or it doesn't exist, I can click Create New Plan. Notice we give you a pop-up here to go create a new plan in Microsoft Planner. And when I click that link, it will take me to tasks.office.com where then I can create a new plan. The reason we do that is the API in the connector does not currently support creating a new plan. So we take you to the spot to create it, and then tell you to refresh the list in QuickTask to select your new plan. Hitting the refresh button right here after you've created a new plan will display it inside of the list. In this example, as I mentioned, I'm using the Power Apps and Flow Applications plan. When I click it, the buckets inside of that plan are automatically populated in this drop-down list. If I don't see the bucket I'm looking for, I can click Create New Bucket and specify a name for it. This one I'll just name after myself and click Create Bucket. Now the list refreshes and I have a new bucket that I named after myself that I can now create tasks inside of. If I head back to my plan now and take a look at it and refresh it, I'll be able to see my new bucket. There it is. It's now ready for me to create new tasks inside of that plan in that bucket as well. I can also select who I would like to assign it to. This is basically an Active Directory people picker we implemented in PowerApps. I have a video about that on my YouTube channel. I encourage you to watch if you'd see like how to build your own. Finally, I can set the date for when I want this task to occur. And as I mentioned, I can also edit the description. Now when I click the Save button, the task has been created. And if we head over to the plan, we can watch it pop up inside of here automatically. Now we can see that that new task was indeed created in Planner right from our Power App. Now I'm going to dive into the code and show you how it works. Oh, wait, one more thing. Let's take a look at that task we created in more detail. Here we can see it was assigned to me, put in the appropriate bucket, the due date we selected in the Power App is there, as well as the description. So all of the information we added in the Power App flowed into this task in Planner. So the story starts inside of the onStart function in the home page of the app. Here you can see I have that function expanded. The things related to Planner start here with this clearCollect function. clearCollect is going to create a new collection called My Plans Gallery Items, and it's going to add an item to it with the ID Not a Plan To and the title Create New Plan. That's how we got the menu item into that particular drop-down list so that we can take a look at the option to create a new plan. After that, then we're going to invoke the Planner connector. If we go over to the View menu and pick Data Sources, we can see inside of our list of data sources our connection to Microsoft Planner right here. Returning to the code up here, now we're going to invoke that Planner connection, and we're going to call the ListMyPlansV2 function, and we're going to return its value. That's going to give all the plans that the current user has access to, and we are going to use the collect function to append them to the MyPlansGalleryItems collection. We are also going to create a new collection using clearCollect called MyBucketsGalleryItems. We're taking the same approach here, where we put an item in right off the bat. We give it an ID called NotABucket2, its name is CreateNewBucket, and its plan ID, because a bucket needs to be associated with a plan, is NotAPlan2. That's the same one as the plan ID we gave to the CreateNewPlan menu item inside of the MyPlansGalleryItems. So as we look at that at runtime, now you can understand how we created the Create New Plan button right there, and also how we created, once you select a plan, how we created the Create New Bucket menu item right here. The next piece of the puzzle is looking at how, when we select a plan, how we return the buckets for that plan. So notice I have the My Plans Gallery control selected. The My Plans Gallery control is the drop-down list that we select plans from. So in the onSelect function for that particular control, notice the code we use here. First, we do an if statement to evaluate if the selected item's ID is not a plan to. Remember, not a plan to is the one that says create a plan. So if we are selected to the one that says show the create a new plan, then the code that we're going to run is to set the show create plan prompt to true. When this particular variable is true, it shows you the box that describes how to create the plan that you saw me walk through when I did the demo of it. Now, in the event that that value is false, the rest of this code under here is what is going to run. So first we're going to set a variable called selected plan to the item that they selected in that gallery when they use that dropdown. The next thing we're going to use is the clearCollect function here. And we're going to create the collection called MyBucketsGalleryItems. And again, we are adding in the CreateNewBucket item just like we did in onStart. Then, here's where we're actually going to get some more integration with Planner API itself. We're going to call the collect function, pass in the MyBucketsGalleryItems collection that we just cleared out and created above with just that create new bucket item in it. And then we're going to call out to the Planner connector right here, and we're going to call list buckets. We're going to pass in the ID of that selected plan that we set right here, which is this item underneath the hood, the currently selected item in the gallery. We're going to pass in the ID value. What that's going to do is, by calling list buckets and passing in the plan ID and grabbing the value that's returned from it, it's going to take all of the different buckets and it's going to add them to the My Buckets Gallery Items collection. So that's how, when you select a plan, you populate the particular collection here that is bound up to the buckets dropdown. So now we've seen how we get the collection that populates the My Buckets gallery. The My Buckets gallery I currently have selected here in the control tree. This is the drop-down list that shows us all of the different buckets available for a given plan. Notice that in its item collection, it uses an if statement. The if statement reacts to the show create bucket prompt. This particular variable is set, as I will describe to you in here in just a little bit. If that value is true, then we are going to filter the My Buckets gallery items to only show the ones where the ID is not a bucket 2, the one that says create a new bucket. If show create bucket prompt is false, then we're going to show everything inside of the My Buckets gallery items. Now we can take a look at how the show create bucket prompt variable is set. This happens inside of the onSelect function for the My Buckets gallery. Anytime an item is selected in that gallery, if its ID is equal to not a bucket 2, which we know is the one that correlates to create a new bucket, then we're going to set that variable to true. If the user has selected a value inside of that dropdown that's not the value that prompts you to create a new bucket, then we'll set the selected bucket to the current item in the gallery. And then we will also set show buckets to false. Now I've selected the create new bucket group here. This group contains all of the controls that create the pop-up that you see here that allows us to create a new bucket. Notice its visibility is controlled when the currently selected item's ID in the gallery is equal to not a bucket 2, which we know is the value for create a bucket, and show create bucket prompt is true as well. This ensures that the user has selected create a bucket item in the gallery, and we have programmatically set this variable to ensure they have tried to create a new item. Finally, to create the bucket, when the create bucket button is clicked right here, this is the code that executes in the onSelect function. First, we set show create bucket prompt to false. This will hide this pop-up as soon as the code runs. Then, while the pop-up is hidden, after you click create bucket, we create a collection, again, named My Buckets Gallery. So what we're doing here is we're taking My Buckets Gallery items, the one bound to the drop-down of buckets you can select, and we are adding to it the buckets ID that is actually returned from Planner. So here we call the Planner, and then we invoke create bucket, and we pass it in the new bucket name. You can tell by the dark green thick underline here that corresponds to that same dark green around the text box for bucket name, that's the actual name of the control. So new bucket name is the text that's typed in to this text box. Then we also take the selected plan from the dropdown above and pass its ID in. So by passing in the name of the bucket as well as the plan ID, we create that new bucket in Microsoft Planner. Now keep in mind here, the collection named My Buckets Gallery Items right here, this one is actually what we're using in our item collection for the My Buckets Gallery. So you can see that down here on the right, or I can also bring it up here on the top, and we can now see how after we create a new bucket and we add it to the collection, it's indeed in the list. And that's why as soon as you're done creating a new bucket, that drop-down list shows it. So returning to the PowerApp at runtime, let's recap what we did. First, we on start go get all the plans for the current user and we load them into the gallery here that has all the plans that user has access to. We also add in the create new plan to this collection of the gallery that's implementing this control. When we select the plan, we make an additional call to Planner to return all the buckets inside of the plan that we see here. When we create a new bucket and enter its name here, just like that, we go and create it in Planner, and then we automatically add it to the collection bound to the control in the gallery that implements this bucket drop-down list. And so now we can see the new one I just made. And now we're at this point where we can create the task. Creating the task is done by clicking the Save button here in the top right corner of the Power App. The onSelect function for this method executes the code that creates the task. Let's open it up here and look at it in more detail. We start with an if statement. The if says if the selected bucket is not blank, then, as you can see here, after the first comma, the true value, this is what we will execute. So when the user has not selected a bucket, we will fall into the second value down here. So to create a plan when a user has selected a bucket and put it into the bucket, we're going to set a variable called taskAdded. The taskAdded is going to be equal to calling the planner connector and then invoking createTask. Here we pass in the selected plan's ID, the task text, which is the value that the user typed in for that. Then we pass in the bucket ID, which is the selected bucket's ID. We pass in the date picker's selected date for the date that the task is due. And then we also pass in the assignments, the assigned to user ID. All of these values come from the little form here on the right side of the page. Now notice if a user has not selected a bucket, as I mentioned, we fall into this second set statement. Everything here is exactly the same, except we merely do not pass in the bucket ID here. When you do that, it will still create the task in Planner, and it will just drop it into the to-do, if I remember correctly, bucket. Finally, when we're done, we set show success to true. Show success, when it is true, drives the success message that pops up after you click the button create the task and see that the task was correctly created. So if we bounce back over to runtime now, here we can have demo email 6. And notice, as I mentioned before, I can type in more text there, and I can also specify additional text down here. This is the user we've assigned to. This is the date that we just saw that it's set for. We have our selected plan and our selected bucket, which we pass in the ID for under the hood. Now when we click Save, that code executes, and the variable is set that showed that we were successful, and it displayed the message that told us it was successfully created. So that's soup to nuts, how you can go get the plans and the buckets, create new buckets and create new tasks in Microsoft Planner from a Power App. One thing I'd like to point out is looping back to what we talked about before when we were not able to create a plan yet from the Planner API. Now, we can see that here if we look at the different APIs available in the Planner connector. We can see we can create a bucket, a task, there's another version of creating a task, getting tasks back, getting task details, listing buckets, listing plans, and updating tasks with a few different versions of the API available there. We hope this Power App comes in helpful for you, not just as a great way to manage email and turn them into tasks in Planner like we've done back here, but also is a great way to show you how to use the patterns on how you can integrate Microsoft Planner and Outlook with your Power Apps as well. Thanks for watching the video. I'll see you next time.